The Ugly Duckling, a bedtime story for adults and children. This bedtime story will start with the story and then we'll move into a meditation. Welcome, my name is Lauren. Thank you so much for joining me for this story and meditation. Before we start, I'd like you to put on loose, comfortable clothing. Make sure you're in a safe space. Declutter that space and ensure that it is warm. Now, this space can be anywhere which suits you, but the aim of this story meditation is your sleep. And you deserve a sound sleep. So perhaps your bed is the ideal place. Prepare yourself, and when you are ready, we will begin. Sit down or lie down comfortably, and we will begin. Start with the breath, noticing the breath, noticing your breath as one would notice the sunset. Simply observing without judgment or expectation. Your breath communicates to you. Quietly listen. Focus on the repetition in and out. Perhaps you'd like to realign your body so that your legs are not crossed, your arms are not folded. If you're lying, allow your legs to fall out to the side, toes to fall out to each side, and palms up. Lengthen your spine, shoulders back, and release. As much as you can release at this stage. Go gently with yourself. Each meditation or each sleep story, you're going to enter this state in a different way. That's okay. The prior moments you have experienced are always going to be different. Accept yourself as you are now. You are doing well. Breathe in and out, focusing on the breath. Release your body as much as you are able at this stage. And invite your mind into this space, this mindful, safe space. Long ago, a long time ago, on a farm, a beautiful farm with fields as far as the eye can see, and a variety of animals. Pigs, goats, cows, chickens, wandering, eating, moving. Imagine, visualize this farm. And in this farm, there is a mama duck. A mother nesting over her eggs, seated on her nest. Imagine the nest lovingly made with her own down. She sits patiently. The sun is warm, the sky is blue. Feel the ambience of the farm. The mother duck is waiting for her eggs to hatch, for her babies to be born. She sits and she waits and she waits and she sits. Breathing in and out, she sits patiently with love. She knows she needs to keep the eggs warm. She knows she needs to tend to the eggs to keep them safe. She breathes in and out. The sun is overhead. And there are wisps of clouds moving over her head. Occasionally, she moves herself slightly to ensure all the eggs are kept warm and cozy. Finally, the eggs begin to crack. Crack. One by one, the eggs slowly start to move and crack. Time passes. And more time passes. The sun is warm, its rays shine down upon the duck. sitting upon her eggs, her precious, precious eggs. One by one, yellow ducklings climb out of their shells. One by one, they shake their wings. And they say for the first time, quack. The hatching of the eggs takes time. And requires patience. The mother is patient. The mother looks down upon her ducklings with love, with joy. Oh, you are so beautiful, my children. Look at you. They all gather together and bundle together in a group hug. Quack, quack. The mother said, come and line up. Let's go together to the lake for your very first swim ever. It's going to be wonderful. She counted her babies. One, two, three, 4, 5. Oh, said the mother duck. One duckling is missing. One egg was left in the nest. It was a large egg, much larger than the other eggs, and a different color. Well, said the mother duck, it looks like that egg is going to take longer time to hatch. So I will wait. So she went to her nest and she sat down lovingly, carefully on the egg. And waited. And waited. And waited. And the sun shone. And the clouds moved overhead. As she waited. A full day went by. and the large egg started to hatch. Slowly, a crack appeared, and then another crack, and another crack. And the big egg hatched. A baby bird came out, but the baby bird looked different to the other birds. It was much bigger. It was a different color. And the bird moved differently. The bird sounded different to the other birds. And when the bird moved, walked, it walked differently. Perhaps you could say awkwardly. One of the yellow ducklings pointed. What is that? That duck cannot be one of us. And another yellow duck said, I have never seen such an ugly duckling. And then another duck also made a judgment that was unkind about the larger duckling. The mother duck said, how can you say such a thing? You are only one day old. This duck hatched from the very same nest as you. It's important you accept each other. It's important you include each other. Protect each other and care about each other. We are a family. We are a community. Now, let's line up and we will go down to the lake. For our very first swim together. An exciting moment for a duck that has just been born. And they waddled down to the lake. Yet as they waddled, as they moved, the other ducklings quacked, ugly, 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 ugly. To the duckling that was different. Ugly, weird, different. The other duck said again and again, ugly, weird, different. And then they started to chant. You're different, you're ugly. You're different, you're ugly. You don't belong. At times, the other ducklings yelled loudly. The different duckling took the last spot in the line. The different duckling felt sad. Each yellow duck jumped in the river and swam behind the mama duck. When it was the different duckling's turn, the different duckling jumped in and started to paddle. The different duckling swam well. They enjoyed the swimming. But the yellow ducklings left out the duckling which was larger and different. The larger different duckling swam alone. When they left the water finally and started to play, the different duckling tried and tried and tried to play with the brothers and sisters. They yelled, "Go away, go away. We will not play with you." You are ugly. And you walk weird too. When the mother duck was close, she would stop the judgment. But she was not always close by. One day, one of the yellow ducklings said to the different duckling, "You know what? You would do us all a big favor if you just went away forever." And then they all started to quack, "Go away, go away, go away." The different duckling said, "Why won't you let me stay here? What have I done?" What can I do differently to be included? Please don't send me away. The different duckling hung its head low. "Perhaps they are right. Perhaps I'm not good enough. Perhaps I don't belong." That night, the different duckling flew away. He flew to the other side of the lake. and remained there for some time, hiding in the reeds. Big tears slowly came down the duckling's face. The duckling didn't want to be different. The duckling wanted to belong. The duckling was sad about what the other ducks had said. And the duckling hung its head sadly. The sky grew dark. There was rain, there was lightning. There was a big storm, heavy rains pouring down from the sky. Listen to the sound of the rain. Pitter-patter, pitter-patter upon the lake. The different duckling hid among the reeds. Thinking about its plight, what to do, how to be. Who am I? The duckling said. Who am I? Who am I really? It was cold. The wind was cold. The rain was heavy. The duckling felt lost, confused. Who am I? The duckling said. The storm went for a long time. It seemed like days. The rain came down, the winds blew. Time passed. And the duckling continued to ask itself, who am I? Why don't I belong? Why did the other ducks judge me? The duckling stayed at the lake all by itself, and time passed. And passed and passed. The leaves of the trees turned a rich red and gold. And gradually the leaves fell down, one at a time. Watch the leaves fall down. See the different colors of the leaves as they fall slowly to the ground. And then, over time, snow fell. A blanket of white snow everywhere. A cold wind dark clouds. The different duckling felt lonely and sad. Who am I? Who am I? The different duckling went into the lake every so often and fished and fed itself. The different duckling was cold and not comfortable, but resilient. Found ways to hide from the weather and fish. And the different duckling grew. And grew. Gradually over time, spring came. Green leaves covered the trees. The sun came out. The sky was blue. Beautiful flowers opened and greeted the sun. The young duckling spread its wings. It felt strong. Its wings felt strong. The duckling had made it through the seasons. Resilient, independent, finding its own way, finding places to hide and keep warm. At times a shed, or perhaps a little cave, or among the reeds. The young duckling was strong, resilient, independent, and found its own way. To get through the winds, the storm, the weather. The sun was out. The duckling heard quiet splashing sounds. Behind him and turned around. There was a flock of the most beautiful birds the duck had ever seen. In the sky, and then they landed on the water. They were beautiful. Just beautiful long necks, beautiful beaks. They were so graceful. The different duckling looked at them in awe. Oh, you are so beautiful. As the duckling watched the beautiful birds, swans, they were swans. A tear rolled down the duckling's face. If only I could be beautiful like that. The duckling turned away, and as the duckling turned away, the duckling happened to look down into the water of the lake, and the duckling saw its own reflection. The duckling jumped back in fright, and the reflection jumped back as well. What is this? The duckling stretched his neck and watched the reflection of the beautiful bird stretch its neck as well. The duckling realized the duckling was not a duck. The duckling was a swan. The duckling no longer wobbled around awkwardly. The duckling no longer looked so different. The other swans flapped their wings. And said, "Come with us." And one said, "You can take the lead." So, the different duckling, the swan, took the lead. He took a place at the front of the flock. And all his new friends flapped their wings behind him. The duck, now swan, had got through the seasons. The winter, the autumn, the rain, the sleet, the winds. The different duckling, now swan, had coped with the judgment, the opinions of others. They were wrong. It's okay to be different. The different duckling flew and called out, "Who's an ugly duckling now? Not I." It's okay to be different. The opinion of others doesn't matter. Judgment doesn't matter. We can find our sense of self within ourself. In each of us is a swan. Others may not see the swan in each of us. But that swan exists. Sometimes our journey can be more difficult than other times. But we have infinite resilience. The ability to adjust, to cope. And to move through the storms and the seasons of life. Breathe now in and out. Breathe in and out. Release your body. Release your head. Shoulders. Arms. Hands, legs, feet. It's okay. You're okay. You've got this. Release your body, your whole body. Your legs, your arms, your shoulders, your face. Your shoulders, your arms. Your legs, release. 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 Let go of your physical self. Breathe now in and out. Breathe in and out. Release your body. Release your head. Shoulders. Arms, hands, legs, feet. It's okay. You're okay. You've got this. Release your body, your whole body. Your legs, your arms, your shoulders, your face. Your legs release. 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 Let go of your physical self. It's okay. Breathe now in and out. Breathe in and out. Release your body. Release your head. Shoulders. Hands, legs, feet. It's okay. You're okay. You've got this. Release your body, your whole body. Your legs, your arms, your shoulders, your face. Your shoulders, your arms. Your legs release. 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 Let go of your physical self. It's okay. Okay. Let go. breathe now in and out. Breathe in and out, release your body. Release your head. Shoulders. Arms. Hands, legs, feet. It's okay. You're okay. You've got this. Release your body, your whole body. Your legs, your arms, your shoulders, your face. Your shoulders, your arms. Your legs, release. 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 Let go of your physical self. It's okay. Let go. Let go. Breathe now in and out. Breathe in and out. Release your body. Release your head. Shoulders. Arms, hands, legs, feet. It's okay, you're okay. You've got this. Release your body, your whole body. Your legs, your arms, your shoulders, your face. Your shoulders, your arms. Your legs, release. 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 Let go of your physical self. It's okay. Let go. Let go. Release. Release. Let go of your physical self. It's okay. Release. Release. Let go of your physical self. It's okay. Release. Release. Let go of your physical self. It's okay. Quietly. it's okay. Let go. Let go. It's okay. Release. Release. Let go of your physical self. It's okay. Quietly.